Ladies and gentlemen of the press, fellow activists and concerned Lagosians, this press conference has been necessitated by the urgent need to stop Lagos State from continuing to be a pawn on the chessboard of an individual to be pushed around at will for the purpose of self-centered pedestrianism. Democracy is a concept of collectivity for the greater number of the people to have a voice and a choice to freely choose who they wish to govern them. Democracy was never a conceptualization of domination to be merchandised by a few powerful individuals in the society who choose to arrogate to themselves the power of life and death over a people. The political atmosphere in Lagos State is currently but unnecessarily overcharged due to the shenanigans of one individual desperate to maintain a political stranglehold on the state. It is common knowledge that for the past 11 years, it has become a tradition for the political pendulum of the state to swing according to the whims and dictates of Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, who is an expert in the politics of imposition. The situation in Lagos State is beyond what well-meaning Lagosians should leave to the internal intrigues of the ruling party. It is not about what party we belong to or don't belong, or which ideological tendency you believe in or you don't believe in. It is the collective responsibility of all to ensure that Lagos State is liberated from a circle of certainty that seeks to perpetually determine the political destiny and destination of the state without recourse. It is public knowledge that recently both the traditional and social media have been awash with the rift between the incumbent governor of Lagos State and Ashiwaju Tinubu due to the former's second term bid and the alleged disapproval of the latter. Our main concern here is how that rift is overheating the Lagos polity and is sure to negatively impact on governance in the state. Although both sides are still struggling to live in denial, but it has blown into the open that there is a tangible credence to the political hiatus between the duo. The fundamental reasons why committed Democrats, activists, and regular Lagosians must rise up to the question are: one, if it is true that the cause of the current brouhaha was due to the refusal of the governor to afford the state political sharks access to the state treasury, then it calls for serious concerns by all Lagosians. We've asked the question for the umpteenth time: what caused the current witch hunt of the governor? Mostly, what we have garnered from independent findings was that the governor is allegedly being tormented because he did not dance to the tune of some powerful political forces in the state who allegedly demanded that the funds being used for the developments in the state be shared among them. An issue like this is beyond intra-party matter because it is the very soul of the state that is at stake. It is generally acknowledged that Governor Ambode has done tremendously well in the area of infrastructural development, security, workers' welfare, and so on. Many elsewhere inaccessible areas of the state have been opened up due to persistent road construction, reconstruction, and rehabilitation. Vehicular and pedestrian bridges crisscross the state. Lagos taxpayers are witnesses to the good uses to which their commonwealth is being put. If that is the sin of Governor Ambode, then we urge him to continue sinning. Two, we find it not only preposterous, but also reprehensible to hear that the governor is allegedly being threatened with impeachment by the state assembly should he continue to pursue his second term bid. This is a blatant bastardization of democratic norms and practices. The security implications of such a threat is better imagined if it happens or allowed to happen. For instance, in the 3 years as governor, we are not saying Ambode has been perfect or did not commit errors, but his achievements far supersede his failings, which has endeared him to many Lagosians who are rooting for him for a second term. Therefore, should the alleged threat to impeach the governor be executed, this may lead to an intractable and prolonged breakdown of law and order should Lagosians choose to resist the injustice. This is the larger picture that we all must see and act decisively to end the culture of political impunity, domination, and imposition in Lagos State. Today, whereas in Lagos East and West, senatorial aspirants are fighting for tickets, while in Lagos Central, nobody can dare contest the seat apparently reserved for the wife of Senator Ahmed Tinubu, that is, Pastor Senator Oluremi Tinubu, who is going for a third term consecutively. What legislative prowess can be adduced to the latter to merit a perpetual relay between Lagos Central and the upper legislative chamber? That is what politics of imposition, domination, and intimidation agendas. It is being alleged that it is Senator Remi Tinubu who masterminded the sudden emergence of Mr. Sanwo-Olu as the anointed governorship candidate of Lagos by the powers that be. It has been alleged that he is a mere decoy for the real power game that is unfolding. We have it on good authority that he is being imposed to be governor for only one term, and thereafter paved the way for Senator Oluremi Tinubu to become governor of Lagos State. That is the level of disdain to which the hegemonic political dynasty of Lagos State holds Lagosians. Lagos State cannot continue to be in the pocket of Fashoaji Tinubu. 2019 provides an auspicious opportunity for a mass political revolution by Lagosians to liberate the state from continued political and economic enslavement. Lagos State, with a population of almost 30 million people, is a mini Nigeria and cannot continue to pay homage to the insatiable appetite of a political tarantula. We shall kickstart a process of the political revolution in the state immediately. The first stage of the revolution is to mobilize a minimum of 50 political parties in Lagos State to adopt Governor Ambodi as their governorship candidate. A contact and liaison committee has been set up to actualize this project. However, fortunately, names of some credible Lagosians have been mentioned as being interested in throwing their hats into the ring of the governorship race in Lagos State, notable among of whom is Mr. Femi Otedola. Lagosians will be presented with a constellation of formidable, credible, and resourceful Lagosians who will help generate not only a fresh political atmosphere, but new ideas to move Lagos State forward from the old order. Having been a successful businessman and a political virgin, so to speak, Femi Otedola might just be the messiah to break the almost 20 years of tarantula stranglehold on Lagos State and Lagosians. The Babasokwe political malaise that has bedeviled Lagos State for so long has to be permanently disabled to enable Lagosians freely choose their political leaders, not only at governorship level, but also National Assembly, State Assembly, local government areas, and LCDAs. From councillorship to governorship, it's time for Lagosians to refresh our political leadership. Various young people in different political parties like COA Party, PPA, AA, Accord, etc., are coming out with young, intelligent, patriotic Lagosians who are full of new and productive ideas that will help Lagos State. Can they identify them and vote for them in order to vote out this moribund political order? Lagos is not a family heritage bequeathed to any individual, and therefore cannot and should not be treated as such. We are confident that more credible Lagosians, untainted by corruption and maladministration, will still join the race to Alausa. It provides the most auspicious opportunity for us all to remove the political albatross of Lagos State for good. This is the collective responsibility of all Lagosians and a sacred project to which we must unidirectionally commit ourselves. Moreover, LADVOS, as an umbrella organization for the five organizations that form this coalition, will effectively utilize its structures in all the wards, local government areas, and LCDs of Lagos State as effective machinery of mobilizing Lagosians for the mother of all socio-political revolutions in Lagos State. The crowd you see here today are a few of our cadres drawn from all the wards and local government areas of Lagos State. If Nigeria must experience real and positive change, it will start in Lagos with the 2019 general elections. The Lagos behemoth shall be dethroned, and Lagosians shall be set free. It is a non-negotiable process to which we have committed ourselves, and there is no going back. There has to be a time when the people must rise and say enough is enough and stand their ground. That time is long overdue in Lagos State, but never too late. The time is now. Together, let's do it. Thank you for your listening attention. My name is Comrade Mark Adebayo. I'm the convener for the Lagos Democracy Advancement Forces.
Thank you. Lagos Democracy Advancement Forces being all this while, that it is counting your number now, 11 years after, that you want to dethrone this behemoth. Where have you been? Because someone will ask you that you are crying more than the bereaved. The governor has come out to say there is no rift between him and his predecessor, so to say. So if you are standing for democracy, what is wrong in having three aspirants jostling for a ticket?
Eventually, some of the things that are happening, you know, if you look at the tradition and the political trajectory of Lagos State since 1999, or let me say from 2003, or 2007, when Fashola became governor, and when he wanted also to run for second term, there were this kind of hues and cries and crises and troubles, and there were rumors of him being denied the second term. Of course, they were denying. Of course, all of us are witnesses to the fact that those things were settled. When he went to collect his nomination form, eventually, he would discover that all the people who have been saying they wanted to aspire to the governorship did not eventually go to collect their form from their party, you know. So, but this time around, you can see that that tradition has been broken. Now, of course, 2 days ago, we saw local government chairman and LCD chairman and chairperson sitting down and endorsing somebody else rather than the governor. So the issue is that crying more than the bereaved is not relevant to the current situation, because in any case the bereaved cannot cry. You know, if somebody who is dead doesn't cry, it is the people that are alive who are crying, because the real bereaved is the dead. And of course, you know, the thing is this, if you keep quiet, you know, there's something they call in international relations, they call it negative externality. And meaning that if you keep quiet while your neighboring state or country is messing up big time, you will discover that is what is happening in America and Europe and the rest of them now. Look at how many thousands of kilometers from the Middle East to Germany, for instance. There were crises there. There was war there, engineered by the Western forces. Now, those countries have become failed states. Libya, Syria, Baghdad, Iraq, and co. So the people are now moving en masse to Europe and the Americas. So what is happening now? They have problems there. The crime rate in Germany in the last 1 year has increased by over 75%. So what are we talking about? If you keep quiet, that is why we are saying that there are fresh brains, fresh faces coming out to say we want to be governor. We do not have to be entrapped in this shenanigan of an individual. That is the major message. And the fact is this, if we keep quiet and say, oh, it's their issue, it's their party, it's their, no, we are all Lagosians. Whatever is happening in this country today, you know, the issue of terrorist harassment, killing people all over the country, the issue of the economy going down the drain, the issue of horrible insecurity. All of us are bearing, whether you voted, you did not, or you didn't vote, whether you are a politician or not, whether once you are a Nigerian, whatever is happening at the level of leadership should concern you if you don't want to be consumed by the aftermath of misgovernance. So we don't have to wait to allow that to happen. Lagos State. That's why we said the revolution must start in Lagos State. In any case, some of us have been around for so long, for so long. The people you see here on this table will be at the forefront of a democracy. We are part of NADECO, we are part of all the movements, even our students are part of the movement. Comrade Rahim, the chairperson of Coalition Against Bad Governance, against corruption and bad governance, has been around for as long as I can tell. So We only came together under one coalition. It is not that we are just starting today. And if you keep quiet, aside from the fact that we are saying that, look, it is very, very wrong for one individual to be determining the political fate of a state, we are also rooting for younger politicians that Lagosians should identify these other people that are coming up, so that you can break the stranglehold. You know, this is not, Lagos State as a macrocosm is not the heritage of any family. If that is the only reason why we are coming out, we are going to do it. We are going to do it.
Why now? Is it that you are no longer benefiting from Tinubu himself? Let's just mention them. Or something is about to change. And secondly, you mentioned all the local government chairmen in Lagos signing to support Sowore. That's not true, because I particularly put a call through to more than 7 local government chairmen, and they denied it, that they never signed anything, and they were not even at the meeting held at Watercrest Hotel. So if you are actually calling us here today, please. If you were actually calling us here today to throw a light to what people out there don't know, what do we need to believe from your side? And what do you think we need to do that you are not telling us?
Thank you so much. You know, it's their own word against ours. I'm sure you saw, I'm sure you must have seen the video.
Of course I did.
And that, and of course you would, was it yesterday? Two days ago, the governor he came out and said all the things about him and Tinubu. Yeah. Fashola said so. It's not new. How many of the Lagos State local government chairman do you know by faith? So, you are telling me that you watched that video, you did not see any Lagos State local government.
I'm not denying the fact that
so
I never
the
saw
seven you called,
chairman, but I put a call through to some and they denied being there.
Okay.
So that's why I said you should not bring it together that all the local government chairmen in Lagos.
We should not say all of them. Okay. We want to avoid the negative generalization. Yes, you are right. Yeah, I mean that all of them were not there. And you understand, you will know that the emergence of this local government and LCD chairman, you know what happened before the emergence. Some came from the Lion of Bodilon, while some came from the governor. So those people who came from the governor will find it very, very difficult. Of course, you know that some of them now, they are not even free to move around. So if anybody understands the politics of Lagos very well, we understand that, you don't expect a politician to come out and tell you the truth. Even when they are about to, like Babangida said, we are not only in government, but we are also in power. You know, so people, they say it's politicians who promise to build bridges where there is no river. When you ask him, why didn't you build the bridge? He said, but the bridges are meant for rivers. But he was the first. So. You deserve some level of. But let me answer the more before I allow Alaji to come in. The issue of benefiting from Tinubu and Co. You do know, like Yorubaland is called some people Abishijobi. You know, whoever want to dine with the devil must have a very long spoon. But you can never have a long enough spoon to dine with Satan, because it will eventually. It's like somebody riding at the back of a lion. You end up in the tummy of the lion. So. As an activist, I have no, if that were to be the situation, I would not be here today. I would not be here today, you know, facing the cameras, facing the public, facing the media, and be talking about people who did it in the past. they know what happened to them. So we are not for that. If that is the case, we will not be talking about other people in other political parties. You understand that people, Lagosians should look for them, find them, and then bring them in. The important thing is that Lagos State of all states, with the level of education, with the level of enlightenment, with the level of exposure, with the level of sophistication, probably the most sophisticated city in the whole of Africa, should not be at the apron string of one individual. It just had to be broken. That is our major concern here. Thank you so much.
First of all, sir, I would like to appreciate this effort. But I do not know why you are doing this. It's obvious, and the man must die for something. But politicians in Nigeria are not voters. They don't want to be fought for. This thing you are doing will be shot down by mass dispensation. The person you are fighting for, or what the position you are taking up, might be the one who is fighting against you. So it is always like that. But I want to say this. Have you had the governor or the governor in the past, what they signed with this private person? Because it is, you cannot just come into, I mean, out of nowhere, bring someone to come and rule over 30 million people without you signing something, or shit, wow, because about so little deal. You know, if the person has signed that thing, like you said, I'll be sure to journey with the devil, of course, you must follow the rule. So, if the rule is not being followed, I mean, the consequence must take effect. So, have you had this position you are taking? If there was any signing or any contract that has, okay. I mean, joined them together.
My brother, please, let me quickly. Well, one of the things, who we are fighting for here are Lagosians, not one individual. I want to clear that. Number two is the fact that the private contract of anybody with anybody has nothing to do with the social contract of Lagosians with the people they elected into governance.
So,
it is wrong. It has to change. That is why we are starting the revolution now. It has to change. It cannot continue. You cannot continue to be having people who are going to, what's that shrine in Anambra State?
Okija.
And be determining the political fate and fortune of the people. It has to stop. So, both the person who asked them to come and sign, if that is the case, I don't know of anything, any contract, this thing that they had, and the person signing, this society cannot afford them again. If somebody cannot come out and say, I want to contest for political office, and you cannot meet with the people and promise them, give them their manifesto, and on the basis of which they are free to choose you, but after electing, if they, why didn't they use the agreement to go to INEC and say, we have had an agreement, we have won an election? No? Was it only Ambodi that contested the 2015 election in Lagos State? There were other political parties, that was PDP. It was a hotly contested election. So, if that's what they are doing, they are not fit even to be councillor of their street. I'm not talking about a whole world now. They are not fit. So we cannot. For how long are we going to hand over the machinery of governance of Nigeria to the forces of darkness? If that is the case, it must stop. So it's not about speaking for anybody. I am not an appointee of the governor. He has never. In fact, I've never sat one on one with him in my life. You understand me?
Maybe that's why you are.
So, and then look at. I want you to look at it this way also. So, I don't know whether I'm benefiting from this people who have come out under Action Alliance, after under Accord, and rest of that I've mentioned their names here. The thing is that whatever we do to break the stranglehold of the political tarantula of Lagos State, it has to be done. That's why when people say Buhari cannot be defeated, I just look at them as I don't know, walking corpses. I want, because what is that? What can, it shouldn't be Nigerians even talking like that. These are people we have to fight. Is it what is happening? You said it's all over the place. Godfather is, but that the fact that it has been happening for long, and it is all over, it is everywhere, does not make it right. Alaji.
Well, thank you so much, my brother. I think I will start with you. First of all, I wouldn't have expected a journalist to have said Godfatherism must be entrenched in our political system. You see, in fact, the fact that what we practice in Nigeria or in Lagos State in particular now is politics of Godfatherism. Somebody call it voodoo democracy. Mm. A democracy in which somebody must pay homage to a person before he or she could get elected. You just have to change, you have to change the system. Lagos State belongs to every one of us. In fact, Nigeria as a country belongs to every one of us. And we should not allow any person, not even Tinubu, to hold up to ransom. You see, some of us here does not even have a body in our good book. But what we are saying, exactly. The greatest Nigeria that ever lived, the best president Nigeria would have had, the best of Sigan, how everyone said, stand for what is right. Even if you are standing alone. What we are saying here is that the so-called Mr. Tinubu, the Abushuaju of his own elements, people of his likes, has no right to impose any person on us as Lagosians. And that's exactly what we are talking about. In fact, for him to have made such a statement, either directly or through some people, is a flagrant abuse of our constitution. Every person, including yourself and myself, we have rights to contest any election. It is our political right. So the first moment to have not sat somewhere and said this person must run, this one, another person must run. And that's why we are saying it must put an end to politics of Godfatherism. You will agree with me, some of us at a certain time, we have advocated for independent candidacy. Which means, even without running on the platform of any political party, we should also be able to run and contest for elections. And my brother there, please, you see, when we look at it from a legal angle, the fact that somebody forced you to sign an illegal document is a nullity. From which part of the Electoral Act, from which section of the Constitution is selfish interest? You got it right. And for you to have mentioned that selfish right means what they are doing, what they have been doing since 2019-1999 is wrong ab initio. And there's no other name to be given to it. Must we allow that person? Are we saying that Lagos State belongs to a single person? Is it the property of somebody? As a Yoruba man, you see, I'm always happy to identify myself as a Yoruba man. Yoruba, there is a saying in Yoruba that says, "Me only waku, koni jo yele babe." This thing belongs to every one of us.
Yes. Where are you putting any palaba ni baba? Where are you putting that?
I'm happy with that your question. Any palaba ni baba? And that's talk about the culture of us as Yorubas, that we must respect elderly people.
So
I'm coming. It's a question. You have put the question to me, and it's for me to answer. And Abalaba Ali Baba, who you have just said, one, it has to do about our culture. Respect for the elderly ones. Giving honor to someone that has given you direction. Listen, that's why I said giving honor to someone that has given you direction. Like, permit me to say this. Whenever you see the Muslims, the Alphas, whenever they gather to pray, the first thing they will do is only pray for their own teachers, their own of their imams, the person that taught them. And that is exactly what you have just told us now. But we are saying that we have the law, we have the culture. And that's why, you know, you see that certain things that are culture in Yoruba, but even they negate certain reasons from the legal angle. Now, if we say because we are talking about any Abalaba, Ni Baba, you have given me respect for giving you direction. You have given me honor, which is this house, for giving that direction. Does it not mean that person must perpetuate himself in power forever? No, it's not the position of the law. The law is always very clear. It's always very clear about these things.
Yes, now.
So you cannot hold this. You cannot allow somebody to hold us to ransom. There's nowhere in the Constitution. There's nowhere in the Electoral Act that says that we talk about Godfatherism. It's an illegality which cannot be condoned. And in fact, would agree with me that those of you that are journalists, and that's why I said I should have expected such questions from this, my friend here. Look at the Constitution.
It's for you to answer.
I'm coming. Look at the Constitution. Apart from the legal profession, the only thing mentions is journalism. Which means This fight is a collective fight for how you fight for one of us, for our Lagosians. What disturbs you as a person from not being governor of Lagos State? You see, a lot of things are wrong. We cannot allow them to be taking away our political rights. And that's why when we talk about this so-called yeye nomination forms, if someone asks me to come out and pay 45 million naira for it, for what, 45 million naira to buy a nomination form, what does that mean? As Ghanaian of Ghanaian used to say, he said, when you have presented yourself for electoral electoral contest, it's as if you are ready to carry the load, the burden of the people. Then the people say no. What should you do? You relax. when you are insisting that somebody is coming, he's carrying a load. Let me ask you, no, don't worry. And you insist that load must be given to you. There's something must be wrong somewhere. So you see, my brothers, you have to collaborate with us. You have to join us to ensure that we take back our Lagos State. It belongs to all of us.
Take it back.
I cannot be cannot want to ransom.
Take it
we
back.
Have his wife. His wife is now going. He has aspired to go back into the Senate for the third time consecutively. What has he gotten that even you as a man has not gotten? What has he gotten that the women here have not gotten? There's no condition that yes, the condition that allows it, provided that better person is competent. It's not because of the fact that the government has not decided to be looking at the other side. And thank God that some of us are happy with what is happening in Lagos State with the person of someone like Fuad Oki that has challenged the status quo. That cannot continue like that. Just one way or the other. May God forgive all of us. Some of us in one way or the other, all of us are sinners. It's only God that is perfect. But when you have come to realize that you have perspected the certain thing that is wrong, and you have come out to redeem yourself, what is expected of us, of all of us, is to embrace that person and join you, collaborate with him to ensure that that fight is fought and won.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen of the media, let me, first and foremost, before we close this session, I appreciate you. I like the questions. It shows that this is a real press conference. So, but you know, like Wole Soyinka wrote in one of his books, Demander, he said the dramatist over dramatizes himself once too often. And that is what is happening with Tinubu in Lagos State. He has overreached himself. He has overreached himself. And he has over dramatized himself. And we just have to stop the drama. Lagos State cannot continue to be the theater of one individual. So we like the fact, you know, we can't blame the media for asking questions because they have to play the devil's advocate. So because the people we are talking about, none of them is here, they don't have representatives here. So I know this is what we have experienced. When you are live on TV, they will say they are so good because nobody wants anybody to come and close down the station. So that is quite okay. Because in any case, if there are the people, aside from the Nigerian people themselves, ourselves, the people that really are critical stakeholders in this country, in this nation, in this democracy, are the media. During the pro-democracy struggles, we know how many journalists were killed. How to imagine in Nigeria called guerrilla journalism. Journalists should be at the forefront of fighting this cause. Unfortunately, the people who hold this government in control and in charge of the media, both print and electronic, and they say who pays the piper dictates the tune. I know there are papers, there are stations that would never have the liver to hear what we are doing here today, you know, because you don't want to lose your jobs, you know. You know, I was studying something about journalism in Africa and discovered that Nigerian journalists are the worst treated. So, one day, we come, and there's nowhere in the world, there's nowhere in history, where successful revolution has taken place without the active participation, even the 1917 revolution in France, you know, without the, 1789 revolution in France, without the active involvement of the media. And that is why ignore the media to your peril, whoever you may be. And that is why Donald Trump is sinking in America. 36% approval for leadership. You know, it has never happened with past 7 presidents in the United States of America. So We are all in this together. Please, let's go back to the days of investigative journalism where things unseen, unknown by the ordinary eye and the regular Nigerian like us, we see. I think you call it, that's the name you call that. So, you, young man, sorry, I don't want to. But please, let's have these two questions and let us round off.
No. If eventually the elections go in, what plans have you put in place to ensure that every vote counts? Because you are championing for people to come out and vote.
And contest. Yes.
So how do you ensure that each person's vote actually counts? Because at the end of the day, since they're at the helm of affairs, they can switch things over. How are you working towards that?
You know, if I may quote one German philosopher, one of the problems we have is that counting of votes is different from vote counting. So you can vote, it will be counted. So they say your votes have been counted, but they won't count if what you voted for was not the package you received. So for us, I won't deny the fact that we have our own handicaps. There are institutions, EMBs, election management bodies, who are supposed to, you know, to be in charge of making sure that you vote, you count your vote at your ward. I'm not in your ward, you are not in my ward. You don't know what was counted in my ward. I don't know what was counted in yours. But of course, figures will come out. It does not matter whether you snap it and put it on social media. When it gets, there's a place, there's a devil's palace that is called collation center. That is why all the magics and the abracadabra, political abracadabra, will take place. That is the devil's palace. Collation center. That is a major issue. If we are able to amend our electoral act to say that elections will be uploaded directly from polling units. That is the only to eliminate the devil's palace, collation center. That is where. So now you know. It is the political parties. You know what? One of the problems we have, also, you know, every political party has agents in all the wards and polling booths that votes are being counted. Eventually, you will see somebody who's an agent to somebody signing a result that he or she knows is not right because of some little naira. Okay, if you are as an agent, they are giving you 500 naira to go and stay in one polling booth for a whole day, and you get there, somebody's giving you 10,000 naira. Sign this thing now, collect 10,000 naira. You do that. So it is the responsibility of the advocacy. Like I did tell you, we have cadres in all the wards and local government areas of Lagos State. We want to tap into that to ensure that there is a change. What we want to do, we may not openly support any candidate, but what we want to do is to say that the devil you know, you must reject for the angel that you don't even know. I think it's better that way, that to stick with the devil that you know. The devil that you know has done enough damage. We have to get rid of that devil. So, last question, please. Your name, your medium, from? Okay, yeah. Okay, the Ajibule Collective, yeah. Good.
We discovered that from the grassroots, there's a lot of challenges we face, most especially from all these cultural fathers believe that, no, you don't fight the elderly ones. You leave it for them. They are the ones. Whenever they are doing something wrong and you want to challenge them, it is possible, no, there is a lot of gap within the media and the people within the grassroots level. In as much that whenever you want to fight them, fighting them that we broadcast it, we make a lot of backup that we make people to be fighting for their rights. Whenever we are voting, we discover that there is a lot of things that we take away. And when you are doing all these kind of things, we discover that there is nothing that is being right within all those people. And I discovered something. When we are doing things, when we are facing challenges, gradually. They will come to come and task everybody within the community. But when something is coming, they will just sideline themselves, picking people among themselves in order to do things. Why is that?
Okay, you know, you see, the I'm struggling to what you are saying about you see, what you have said. I wouldn't call it a question. We are just making a general comment that all of us know that is a problem to all of us. You see, the issue is this: our culture in Africa respects elders, and I will defend that culture with my blood, because having traveled to some countries in the world, I discovered that. And that's why I really do not respect people who put European cultures above African cultures. I'm thinking that, because of this negative Westernism. I don't believe in that. You see, respect for elders is to the extent that the elder is not misbehaving. Yoruba, that says we should respect it, that says Agbalagba, Kishi Langba Langba. And it says that Agbalagba also Yongomodi Ofura say Alawada Edie. So it is not a tongue coat thing that it's not a state jacket thing that because he's an elder, he's doing something that is wrong. And then you keep quiet. You know? Yoruba law also we pay any con ego go de be man no more. So if they task you when they want to do something and something is coming, I know you are coding it, and they sideline you.
But
wait, let me answer your question. Let me tell you, the youth of Nigeria will continue to be sidelined, to be marginalized, to be oppressed and repressed until the day you decide to be united. You know why women and youth are suffering? Let a woman come out and say you want to contest for election. I'm not talking about people who have the money and the powers. The people that are, if the woman ever imagines winner, go and look at the percentage of men and women that vote for him. You score that it's 90% of men will vote for the woman. So why 90% of women will go and vote for a man? So as they say, it's the time of women. Well, until they are able to get out of the other room that President Buhari sentenced them and come out and unite to get rid of the other room mentality and begin to support one another, the women will never. The same thing with the youth of this country. You know, look at what has become of your Nance. 30 years ago, when I was in university, Nance was respected and feared by government. Yeah. But now we have four Nance presidents. So until the youth are able to come together, get rid of the Yahoo Yahoo mentality, and know that you have to, be politically involved. Yes. You are lucky, by error, by mistake, by fire, by force, maybe by prayers, President Buhari assented to the not too young to run big, but you have told you to wait till.
Let me finish.
Until I finish. So that is the Agbalagba that you have to disobey. You hear me?
Yes.
That is the Agbalagba you have to disobey to win election. Let's, if you look in this world now, in terms of academics, academically, socially, and every area, for at least when he was alive, the Nigeria must have been 170 million. We celebrated him. We say, hey, you are good. Oh, my jolo mo we yena fishi. You know, so how many folks did our brother, our uncle, Dele Momodu, Ghana, when he ran under? So look, prebendalism will always overpower and overcome patriotism and commitment. I'm talking of money. They have succeeded in impoverishing Nigerians, including our mentality, to the extent that election time has come now. Go see Ekiti. In the government that fights against corruption, Mr. Integrity is our president. Untouchable by corruption, untouchable by stealing, untouchable by looting. But his wife can afford, I want you to quote me live, I don't care, can afford the $8,000 handbag.
Nigerian people.
Yeah.
Is
it's a development.